Sponsored by the Big 98, Nashville's number one for new country and the home of the Bobby Bones Show.
I've been walking this road for so long, I can't see where I'm going, forgot where I'm from. The plan was all perfect when I started out, but crystal clear vision got shattered by doubt.
Welcome to the Rock Interview. I'm thrilled to have on Cy Young Award winner, two-time World Series winner, Barry Zito, with a brand new book out, Curveball.
Yes, sir.
And what a great book, Barry.
Yeah, well, thanks. You know, I came to Nashville in 2015 and started writing music after I retired, and then took off about 2 years to write this book, and it's just been such an incredible adventure.
You know, it's such a testament, too. You and I were talking, you know, before we came in the studio, even how, you know, you getting the fame and success and everything like that, and you got it all, and then it wasn't fulfilling, and you want to make sure as well that, you know, families and especially, you know, kids and everything in sports know you got to have some balance.
Absolutely. I mean, you know, I'm a father now, and a lot of this book is from a kid's perspective, you know, where there was a father kind of really intensely, you know, pushing me to do something, which baseball, like so many fathers do here in this country. But just the downside of that as I got older, because my dad never really said, you know, well, what do you think? Well, what do you want? It was always, I know better, which we should do with our kids. But what I ended up doing was, you know, getting to the major leagues and not actually knowing what I thought or what I, you know, felt about it, and started to be obsessed with other people's opinions of me and obsessed with approval.
Right.
And that's a bad situation to be in.
Well, it really is. You know, and you had 15 great seasons in Major League Baseball. And what also impressed me was, you know, how you started playing the guitar, you know, as kind of like therapy for yourself while you were traveling, like in between seasons and everything. You take a guitar with you, and you had an EP that came out, No Secrets, in 2017 also.
Yeah.
And you're constantly writing music, and so Nashville really fit. I got to bring up this, too, to where I didn't realize, you know, your wife is from Oran, Missouri, so you've got that Missouri connection as well.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, my wife's from Oran. We met in Los Angeles, but we go back to Oran in southeast Missouri quite often, you know, for holidays and seeing her family, and, you know, I do love it. I grew up in a big city in San Diego, so I love small town USA.
Well, you know, it's pretty neat, too. You know, you're born in Las Vegas and then raised in San Diego, but your parents worked with Nat King Cole in Las Vegas. So also you have that musical tie-in genetically.
Yeah, absolutely. My father was an incredible musician. He was an arranger and conductor for Nat, and my mother was a backup singer, and that's how they met. And then he became a talent manager. And when I came along, you know, years later, he was, you know, kind of raising me with those manager chops. And, you know, and I get into that in the book a little bit, is just I became so obsessed with success and winning growing up, and also in my professional career, that I just didn't have an identity or a foundation for anything that was outside of what I did. And I think we can all say that we probably, you know, put too much pressure on our jobs or on success in the world to make us happy. And I think we can all say that, you know, it does help some things when we're paying the bills, but there's a deeper hole, I think, that needs to be filled. And that's kind of what I get into, because I certainly thought, you know, $1 million or a Cy Young was going to, good.
Well, and, you know, at the time, too, you were, you know, the highest paid pitcher in Major League Baseball, which is kind of like, wow.
Yeah, and that was, you know, that brought a lot of pressure. I put too much pressure on myself, again, because I was obsessed with justifying the contract instead of just saying, hey, man, I'm just throwing this ball the best I can.
Right.
I am actually, I'm not taking responsibility for everything that's happening after that. And, you know, that's a real clean mindset. That's how I think we should approach everything, is
definitely,
I can only do what I can do.
Right.
And we give the rest up.
Well, it's an amazing, too, you know, you and I were talking to where, you know, being married and having two young boys kind of changes your perspective on life, doesn't it?
Yes, it does. Absolutely. Once again, something becomes more important than, you know, for me, my job was always important. And when I had children, well, I get home from work now and it's, you know, I hug those kids and it just changes everything.
Right. That's a balance of life.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Well, and I think it's so neat, too, with your music and everything. I know you're working on, you know, some more new music coming out the next year or so. But No Secrets is still available also as an EP, right?
Yeah, the No Secrets EP was kind of my maiden voyage with recording a record and just songs that I'd written by myself and co-written in town here. And just songs really about the journey of, again, you know, being this, you know, partially famous baseball player for a while, but a lot of the negative things that had happened. So there's some sad songs on there for sure.
Right.
And my wife inspired some songs as well. But yeah, the music thing's a huge factor, but you know.
Well, and also like you said too, the songs also tie in well with Curveball, the book.
Yeah.
Because they come from your heart.
Absolutely.
You know, and just like when you opened up, you know, the show, it's like, you know, walking this so long, it's like, you know, that's kind of all of us.
Yeah.
Trying to find our way. But it's amazing when you got, you know, a family to greet you at home.
That's
it's
right.
Like, you know, okay, I'm getting this now.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, I think really we just have to ask ourselves what's the most important thing in our lives.
Right.
And a lot of us would say it's work. It's what I'm doing. Mm-hmm. You know, even those with family and, you know, there's lots of people under financial strain. But I think when we have something that's more important, you know, than all of that, which for me was, you know, finding God after so much struggle and pain in baseball.
Right.
Not really ever having heard of God before growing up. I kind of grew up in an Eastern background. So, and that the book kind of gets into that whole journey too, as seen through the eyes of baseball.
Right. But it's also so honest. I think what you've done here, and obviously it took you 2 years to write it, Barry, but it's just, it comes across as so honest and showing that, you know, success isn't always, you know, everybody dreams. It's like, oh, I want to be successful and all that. And really it's not all it's cut out to be sometimes when you get there. You've got to enjoy things along the way.
Oh, absolutely. And also, too, you know, being a kid with a father that was, you know, what I interpreted was so obsessed with winning and success.
Right.
You know, I ended up going off the deep end with drugs and selling drugs, you know, at 15 years old
right.
to just have something that was my own.
Right.
And I think, you know, as I raise my kids, that's what I want to make sure I don't do is to just be so myopically focused on one part of their life
right.
that all the other parts start spiraling out of control.
Totally. Well, I got to ask you this, too, with you playing guitar and everything around the house, are the kids kind of taking the music a little more also?
They are a little bit, yeah. Well, I have a drum set in my studio, so my five-year-old comes in and bangs them, and of course, I'm trying to protect my ears,
yeah, right?
Right. That's my asset, and so I'm always doing this, and he's hitting that snare drum and throwing the sticks, you know?
So you might have, like, your own little, like, you know, Zito family band coming up, maybe.
Yeah, like the Partridge Family.
Yeah, yeah. Maybe you need a bus.
Yeah, that's right.
You know, you can write the songs.
We'll get an old VW bus.
I think this could work.
Yeah.
It's a good plan. Well, I want to make sure our viewers know the new book, Curveball, just came out this week, and you can find it at your bookstores. You can find it online. Also, Barry is going to be doing some great book signings. So what's the best website and social media for the viewers to find you, Barry?
Yeah, we'll have some of the book signing stuff up on BarryZitoMusic.com, and also the socials are at BarryZitoMusic for all those. And yeah, I hope we can get out to a little Southeast Missouri action.
You know what? I think you might be able to have a line of people buying and wanting a copy of this and you signing it at the Barnes & Noble there in Cape.
Absolutely.
Just a theory. You know, and plus you got Las Vegas, you got San Diego. Look at all the places you call home.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, it's a big voyage there, the baseball life.
Yeah, well, and I also wanted to bring up, you know, that your EP is still available on the websites also.
Yeah.
And you're working on some new music, constantly writing. And maybe you're going to post up some clips of your drummer that you're going to have so we can actually see how the skill set's coming along.
Yeah, we need to do that on the socials. Get him, yeah, he's like Keith
Moon. He can be your opening act at the Barnes & Nobles and the different bookstores.
There you go.
Hey, I'd like to have my son do a little drum solo first, and then I'll do the book signings.
Oh, yeah. We'll give away free earplugs for everybody. I'll get
that
the first set.
That could be the sponsor.
Yeah, that's right.
Right there we go.
There you go. You're really good.
Well, I'll tell you what. It's a great book. Be sure and get your own copy. Curveball by Barry Zito. Find him when he's out doing the book signings. Also, look for more of the music. Man, I love your songwriting. And I got to bring this up, too. You did that song for the Nashville Sounds a while back.
Yes, I did.
And that got some big attention, too.
Yeah, that was fun writing the theme song for that.
That's not a bad thing, man, when you could do something. I mean, you're really feeding, you know, your music now as well.
Yeah.
And I'm looking forward to hearing more out of that.
Well, I appreciate it, man.
Well, it's get your fun. Own copy. Curveball, I think you're going to love it. And go see Barry live. He's going to be doing book signings and hopefully more music shows as well. Thanks for watching The Rock Interview.
Sponsored by the Big 98, Nashville's number one for new country and the home of a Bobby Bones Show.